very intimately. Actually, the word intercourse means to know another person. And so as you have sex with your husband, you truly get to know them. It's the most intimate form of knowing another person. That's why God wants you to save this gift for your husband. A person who's never had sex with another person is known as a virgin. Virginity is a gift that God has given you. It's a special gift. And the challenge for you, because you can only give this gift away one time, is to wait and save this gift to give it to the person that you love most, and that's your husband, after you're married. You know, this point is a big part of why the Passport to Purity weekend has occurred. We're all here to help you protect this gift that God has given you. Virginity is a gift and a treasure that you need to decide this weekend to protect. You know, that reminds me of a story of a friend of mine who had a teenager who was being teased and taunted by his friends at school for being a virgin. I mean, they were really making fun of him. They were chiding him and saying, "Aren't you going to really be a grown-up? Aren't you really going to act like you've got it all together and have sex?" Finally, he'd had enough, and he turned to them and said, "You know, at any point I wanted to, I could become just like you. I could have sex. But you can never again become like me. You can never become a virgin again." You know, that young teenager decided in advance that he was going to protect that gift for his spouse after he was married. Now, a part of what makes all these decisions in protecting virginity and staying away from sex so difficult is because of point number 4 in your outline. God designed sex and marriage to bring you a great deal of pleasure. Now, earlier, I shared with you that married couples enjoy sexual love. You know, God isn't down